Okay, people. So. Now I'm walking down 145th Street. I got my tea. Ooh, look. More flowers. What other city they do that at? Now we got yoga place, waxing, the library. But whatchamacallit? Like the goal is to save these videos and put them on my YouTube page, but I keep recording videos that's too long and they won't save. So you know, whoever watches them, watches them. I just want you to see a piece of New York. Yes, I am back in New York, Thomas. See, across the street we got the sneaker and clothing store. But there's more on this side of the street that we're gonna pass. I'm walking to Broadway. Right now I'm up on, there's another barbershop I'm passing. Just passed another barbershop that I couldn't show you. But right now I'm up on Sugar Hill. I'm top of Sugar Hill. I'm on 145th Street walking towards Broadway. There's so much to show you in New York. There's so much to show you in Harlem. I really need to start doing little walking tours in New York to put people on, because people don't know where to go. Oh, look. Across the street, what do we got? First of all, we got another deli. That deli sells hookah fucking containers and shit. Beauty supply store. Jimbo's Burgers. What else? What is that? That's this clothing store. Another barbershop next to the clothing store. Then on that block alone, there's a barbershop and a hair salon. There's sneaker stores over there. Then we got another hardware store. Salons. And again, another salon. How many damn salons have we passed? Let's see. Yeah, there's a sneaker store across the street. And see, look, Spanish. Dominicano. Dominicans own this area. Some people think this is Spanish Harlem because there's so many Spanish, but it's not Spanish Harlem. Got whatever kind of store this is, they got everything you can need even. And across the street, there's a clothing secret store. Look, another unisex salon. And what we got, clothing store with clothes and sneakers as we approach Broadway. Then we got the liquor store again and CVS thing. So much shit. And then right by the Hudson River. Like, you can't see it, but those green trees, those trees you see over there, that's actually New Jersey. The light is not good for this. So if I went down there, you would see how beautiful it is. I didn't plan on walking down there, but I am gonna walk down there. Cause I got my book bag with me. I came out here to go get some tea, but I was gonna record some of my online classes cause I have online nani egg classes for women. And I needed to record some videos, and so I came outside to do it. And I said, let me show them. Oh, look. Hold up. Got, you can't see it, but there's a Foot Locker right there and more fruit stands. You can't see it. And I'm gonna walk down this hill. This hill, ooh, it's pretty steep. You saw that New York garbage too. New York does have a lot of garbage, it's true. But a lot of the dopest cities do. When I was in Colombia, Medellin, which is a dope city, lots of garbage. Havana, Cuba, lots of garbage, but they're dope cities. New Orleans, oh, here we go. got the Harlem brownstones. So, and these houses are huge on the inside. And then we got Riverbank State Park. I'm not gonna go in there because it's so huge, but there's all kinds of basketball courts, there's a ice skating rink, baseball field is lit over there. Like, there's so many parks in New York, and there's so many parks in Harlem in particular. Like, Harlem has more parks, I think, than any other neighborhood in New York. There's parks everywhere, no matter what direction I walk, and there's dope parks. I'm not gonna go in that park because it's too fucking big, and I don't feel like doing all that. I gotta pee. That's the thing, you can pee in New York parks because we got rocks and bushes and shit. So, I just wanna show you down this street. This is Riverside Drive, one of my favorite streets in New York. It's a very quiet street. This street doesn't have any businesses. Oh, go ahead. I'm just gonna show you some stuff over here. See, we're facing the sun, so but there's all kinds of athletic complex over here. And you see, people say we don't have trees in New York. Look at this. Now, I'm gonna go right over and look over. So that's the Hudson River, and then that's New Jersey. So we can see New Jersey. I'm not going in the state park because I don't feel like it right now. But you see, in New York, you can step out of the craziness right into a dope-ass park, into nature. Let's walk over here for a second. Let's see. We have a real park culture in New York, and it's one thing I love. Now, you see these trees? These are big, old, huge-ass trees. When I'm in Chicago or Atlanta, the parks, they have these little baby trees that are strategically planted, and they're so flat. Now, you see this? This is in New York City, and I don't know if you can see that it drops down. Like, this goes down. I don't know if you can see that. But it's like the bush over here. Look down. Like, this is what I'm saying. Like, in New York Park, you could go back here and do what the fuck, smoke crack, have sex, pee, do whatever, and can't nobody see you, pay attention. So, yeah, this is Riverside Drive. Riverside Drive, one of my favorite streets. It's really pretty. And see? Peaceful. Peace fucking full. Okay? So this is 146 in Riverside. Now I'm gonna walk up this steep ass hill. I worked my legs today, so I don't feel like walking up any hills, but you know what? That's what it's about, because I see the old people. Our people walking up the hills here. Also, when I was in Colombia, so it's like, then I feel like, let me stop bitching because my legs are burning. Let me not get run over by any cars. I'm gonna walk up this hill, show you a little bit of Broadway before I take my ass inside. But I feel like hanging out tonight. I want to go get some drinks and do some shit in Harlem, because New York is so lit in the summer, but Harlem is lit. But there's so many lit neighborhoods in New York. I fucking love this city, you know. I do, and I like to put other people on, because you know, you can't always believe the hype about a place. Okay, look. Okay, so I'm walking up this hill, and I don't know if you can see the depth of the steepness of it, but it's pretty steep. You got the more brownstone. See, it's all peaceful and quiet on this block. Peaceful and Then, when we get up to Broadway, it's gonna be Dominican dance party. Spanish everywhere, people being loud, playing music, yada, yada, yada. But then, you know, New York could have a street like that, but then you could turn a corner and be on a street that's so quiet and chill. So the whole city is not loud and crazy that people try to stay. The street that I'm from is not like that. It's more like Riverside, you know? Hold on. My mother was just calling me on the other line. So I'm gonna hop off here real quick. Hold up. Hold on a second. Actually, Buses. We got the fruit stand. See, how many cities you go to? They got fruit stands everywhere. And then across the street, you got a big ass supermarket. But I'm gonna hop off of here because my mom is calling me, and I think it's because she's in the area. I told her to call me when she gets over here, so I'm gonna hop off. But I might turn this back on. And you got a little piece of Harlem. And Harlem is more than just 125th Street. Because when people come to New York and they go to Harlem, they just go to 125th. But you got 145th, you got 135th, you got 116th. All those streets are major streets that are pretty litty. Look at the tourists. Oh, look, another fruit stand, look. Like I said, show me a city with this shit. This is a stand-alone loud-ass garbage truck. I mean, ice cream. We got the Mexican. I might need to get some food from here. Look, she's selling jewelry. You know, what's she selling? They playing chess. And then look, we got more beauty supply, bodega, threading salon, blah 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 blah. Across the street, you got another deli, you got cleaners, you got what the, like, how much shit you need? How you doing? Okay. That's what I'm saying, yo. And when I was on 145th Street earlier, this dude was selling fucking bedroom sheets. Like, who's thinking about buying bedroom sheets on the sidewalk? People be selling, New York people be on their hustle. People be selling bedroom sheets. Oh shit. I just saw some dope shit. I be seeing some dope shit when I had the camera flipped on me. I love New York. There's just so much to look at. So much going on. I mean, look across, look in the middle of Broadway. You got that family doing, I don't know what they're doing, eating? But they're in the middle of the street. They're like, they're in the middle, this is an island in the middle of Broadway. In the world. But then we got tons of parks and yada, 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 yada. So, yeah, you can find whatever you want out here in these streets. And it's not even like Harlem is the only area that's like this. It's like this in Bronx, it's like this in Brooklyn, it's like this in Queens. And I could, if I kept walking for the next 15 blocks, we'd pass another fucking 50 barbershops and salons, another 100 bodegas, restaurants, fruit stands, all types of shit. And these dudes are playing house music, which I hate. That shit runs Chicago. But people listen to house music in New York too, but you can avoid it if you want. Chicago, I feel like I can't escape that shit. But yeah, homie, we got everything. So I'm gonna hop off and go find my mom, who's around here somewhere. I just love being outside in New York in the summer. It's not summertime, but, you know, and it's like, if you watch my other video, you see all the people that kept talking to me. And me trying to shoot this video, besides the fact that I want to be discreet, I don't want people to see me filming them. It's like, when you're a woman, and I got on like what I got on, some little shorts or whatever, then that makes people look at me even more, be like, what is she doing? So I'm trying to be discreet about it, but you see how many people talk to you. People talk to you in New York. If people like some shit you got on, they'll tell you. Like I said, it's not like that a lot of other cities. So when people say New Yorkers don't talk to you and New Yorkers don't, that's bullshit. New Yorkers talk to you so much. And then when you're an attractive woman, they talk to you so much that New York girls walk with their headphones in all the time, hoping that the dudes won't say shit. But New York dudes are so aggressive, that shit don't stop them. You know, they don't care. Okay, so I'ma hop off of here and check out my other video. And if you ever come to New York and you need to know where to go, hit me up, because I'll put you on. I'll make you love my city. All right? Peace.